How does the subconscious mind lead to conformity on the actions one makes and the habits one attains? Habit, psychologically defined as a well-learned behavior or automatic sequence of behaviors that is relatively situation-specific and over time has become motorically reflexive and independent of motivational cognitive influence, is known to be made with little or no conscious intent. According to Harvard professor Gerald Zaltzman, the subconscious mind is known to make up of more than 95% of the choices we make. Whether it be stopping at a red light or saying bless you after someone nearby sneezes, the subconscious mind often leads you to not have to think or process the action that you make or the thoughts that you have. With the inclusion of the subconscious mind, humans can either create good or bad habits, ultimately impacting creativity, conformity, and the patterns in one's day-to-day life. The majority of our actions and habits are built upon the unconscious or subconscious mind. This process is known as cognitive cognizance, which is our brain's way of constantly processing the information beyond our conscience. The work our subconscious mind does often leads to conformity when we are constantly interpreting the stimuli that is in our day-to-day life. Whether it be poor habits, such as the use of drugs or alcohol, or beneficial habits, such as the working out and eating well, the impact peers and adults have was researched by Kathy T. Doe, Ethan M., McCormick, and Eva H. Telzer. Through a study they conducted, a connection between how adolescents balance self and social opinions was reported. 44 adolescents and their parents were put in a trial, and there was 120 of them run. The conductor manipulated social influence in two ways. First off, the type of behavior, whether it be constructive or unconstructive, and second, the types of influence, positive or negative. The results showed that the participants had a mean probability of conforming of 34.8% to their parents' conflicting opinions and 38.8% to their peers' conflicting opinions. This shows society that overall, adolescents are more likely to resist rather than conform to outside opinions. As shown through the experiment run by Doe, McCormick, and Telzer, conformity often doesn't require apparent outside pressures, meaning that most adopt to actions and opinions of their subconsciously. The desire to be viewed in a positive light is a universal desire by much of the human race. Whether it be through social media or simply interacting with those on the street, it is a natural thing to conform to those around you. This act of conformity is shown to be ingrained in your brain even at the age of 2 years old. The desire to retain a likable persona can have its beneficial and detrimental effects on the actions and habits one makes. A negative consequence of this could be a pressure to drink or consume other harmful substances. However, a positive
before
example.
Before school prayer, we'll begin at the chapel in 1 minute. All are welcome to join us for before school prayer, beginning at the chapel in 1 minute.
However, a positive example could be that in many motivational quotes or speeches, it is said that when you surround yourself with people who are hungry for success, you're also more likely to be hungry for success yourself. Aside from habits and conformity, the subconscious mind also may impact the quantity of creativity one attains. One way creativity has been shown to be reduced is through ritualistic synchrony. Ritualistic synchrony's universality has allowed there to be numerous beneficial impacts, such as increased rates of cooperation and coordination. However, a downside of ritualistic synchrony has been found that it can promote conformity, groupthink, and even aggression. With these three detrimental components, all of which lead to reduced creativity, ritualistic synchrony can be considered a poor cultural practice. One experiment in the article, The Cultural Evolutionary Trade-off of Ritualistic Synchrony, included 149 participants, and they were divided into 42 groups consisting of 3 or 4 individuals. After half of the participants were exposed to manipulation, they were asked to create a storyline. Results showed that those who were exposed to synchrony had significantly less creative storylines, and their stories included groupthink. In order to attain creativity in a group of people, it has been shown that it is key to contain 3 different types of people. extremely creative, detail-oriented, and highly conformist. In a study conducted by Harvard student Ella Muir Inspector Miriam Erez and Eaton Nava, 41 radical innovation teams in R&D and manufacturing units were examined. The study showed a side of conformists that is often overlooked. Conformists greatly increase a team's productivity and innovation. Along with this, they also conducted that if there are a large number of detail-oriented people within a group, creativity can take a hit. A quote from Cass Sunstein's book, Conformity, The Power of Social Influence, it touches on the benefit of conformity. The law suggests that most people believe it is wrong to smoke in public places. And if people think it is wrong to smoke in public places, would-be smokers are less likely to smoke, in part because they do not want to be criticized or reprimanded. However, also shown in this book, conformity can lead to aggression, similar to that in the Milgram experiment and the Stanford Prison experiment. In one instance, normal citizens were asked to shock someone depending on their answers to questions, and in the other ones, normal citizens were asked to be guards to other normal citizens who were asked to be prisoners. The subconscious mind enables us to make decisions that make life so much more efficient and timely. Such habits that the subconscious mind allows us to do include washing our hands, brushing our teeth, or saying bless you when someone nearby sneezes. However, like everything else, it is crucial to consider the things where things can go wrong and to be aware of all possibilities.
What's some evidence that you gathered you didn't include, and why did you choose not to include it?
I briefly mentioned the Milgram experiment and the Stanford Prison experiment, and I gathered more information on both of those experiments. However, I didn't wish to include it in my presentation because I thought it took away from the whole idea and focused a little bit too much on aggression rather than creativity and conformity as a whole.
Okay, thank you. What are the implications of your findings to the community?
The implications of my findings on the community can show community that overall conformity exists. However, as shown through the cultural trade-off, it's not as likely as many people assume, especially in adolescence.
Okay, thank you.